up, thinking these women excite me. Keep it up, wishing y'all can pass me. Run it up, stepping, I'm moving. Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Nelly Neff from Hoopin' Life. As sad as it is, we don't got the NBA right now. But on the bright side, we still got some NBA player sneakers going. And today, we have the Nike KD 13s. KD is returning from a torn Achilles from last year's finals and was projected to come back this season where he was going to be rocking these bad boys. But unfortunately, the NBA had to be suspended. And in my hands, I have the hype colorway. These are pretty crazy as it has a Versace-like print of gold chains and butterflies. It has a shiny gold patent leather swoosh, KD logos on the heel and the tongue, and the number 7 for his new jersey number on the side. I was blessed to be able to get a hold of these early as they did release way earlier over here, and I was also very fortunate to be able to hoop in these a few times to get a good feel for them. And yes, for all of y'all wondering, I am very aware of my own safety with everything going on around the world right now, but where I'm at, you know, we are very safe and I'm very grateful to be able to hoop since I haven't been able to do so in the last 2 months. The KD 13 is said to be the most technology advanced sneaker yet. Let's see what it's all about. As always, we're gonna start off with the traction. The KD 13 has a combination of circular and horizontal lines, giving it multi-directional grip on the court. It's very rubbery and sticky, and certain areas of the traction pattern shares the same circular pattern as the PG3s. The traction on these are very on point whether you're hooping indoors and outdoors, which I have done both. Although I've been hooping in these outdoors in like asphalt, I think it's asphalt or concrete. Asphalt, concrete, but y'all get what I'm saying. Like the floor is not nice, all right? And the outsole of the KD 13 have been holding up pretty well. The rubber is pretty hard, so you know, it's very sturdy, you know, when y'all be hooping outdoors. Indoors, without a problem. You know, I cleaned them out really well, you know, before I used them out indoors. Like I said, whether you're hooping indoors or outdoors, the traction on the KD13s are very consistent. Whereas grip-wise, it's very similar to that of the KD12s. For materials, the KD13 has a combination of textile and mesh to give you a lightweight and flexible feel. It has a soft tongue and cushiony collar that enhances all-around comfort. The KD13 definitely is lighter than the KD12s, you know, with it having removing all of the upper that the 12 had on the lateral side. But in terms of feel and comfort, I wouldn't say that the KD13s feel better than the materials on the KD12s. It feels a bit more cheap and hard compared to the 12s, but you know, overall, I think the materials, they get the job done. They get the job done. They're not some premium feeling materials where you feel like, oh my God, like you try these on, the feeling around your foot is like, oh my God, the materials on these are like super amazing. Like it just feels incredible. Nah, you're not gonna get that in the KD13s. I think, you know, with it being very minimal, it gives you very lightweight and, you know, a flexible feel, but you know, it takes away, you know, the premium comfort of the shoe, you know, with it having like, you know, more premium comfortable materials. It just doesn't look that good, let alone, you know, feeling quite amazing. So I think Nike really dropped the ball on the materials on this one. In terms of support and lockdown, they removed the fly wire and all the rubber that, you know, supported the shoe on the lateral side, which, you know, really supported the KD12s really well. And with the KD13s not having all of that, the shoe, you know, is still pretty solid in terms of the support. I didn't feel like the shoe didn't give me a, oh, I don't feel supportive in this shoe type feel, if y'all get what I'm trying to say. The KD13s, pretty supportive in that sense where, you know, even though taking away the fly wire and, you know, the rubber on the lateral side, it was still fairly, you know, supportive. You know, I was able to, you know, slide, play defense without having to roll my foot over, you know, on the footbed. So, you know, that's a good thing. And I think with the KD13s being a mid-top shoe and having a traditional lacing system that really locked down my foot really well, I didn't really have any issues in terms of support and lockdown in these. Although, even having a sculpted heel counter, I wish, you know, the KD13s had a little bit more padding in the heel, especially inside. It is sculpted. It's hard to show you guys, but you know, you guys put your finger in there, you feel that, you know, it is sculpted to your heel. But I just wish it had a little bit more padding to give us more, like, you know, more comfortable feel back there. You know, just to have a little bit more cushion, which I feel like it lacks. But around the ankle area, it's pretty padded. But you know, in the back heel, you see some shoes that have like, you know, those cushioning pads or the cushioning pillows, you know, that really hugs your Achilles. And you know, guys, knowing that KD, you know, ruptured his Achilles last year in the finals, you would think that Nike put more padding in there, you know, to really hug the Achilles. I wouldn't say that that's a definite blow to the shoe in terms of like the support or, you know, the lockdown, but you know, it would have been nice to have more cushioning pads back there. I don't think anybody would disagree with that. For cushioning, the KD13 has a full-length Nike Air Zoom cushion that follows the shape of your foot, providing an ultra-responsive sensation and a smooth heel-to-toe transition. And in the forefoot, there is a second Zoom Air unit that is stacked underneath the full-length Zoom cushion to help enhance explosive movements and amplify energy return. Y'all remember when I said the KD12s have one of the best, if not the best, cushioning setup of all time last year?
The cushioning setup on the Nike KD12s is
one of the greatest cushioning setups I've ever played. Yeah, I think it still kind of holds that trophy. With the KD13s, they had a very similar setup, but I think a little bit better, but not as good. This is what I mean. The good is that, you know, they took the double stack Zoom Air unit from the heel and placed it in the forefoot. Y'all always heard me say that, you know, if you were to put the good stuff, you know, for the cushioning, if it's not full length Zoom, if you had to decide whether you put it in the forefoot or the heel, y'all always heard me say that, you know, put it in the forefoot. I think, you know, as hoopers, we're more on our forefoot compared to, you know, in our heels, you know, whether you make movements or jumps. I think the forefoot is a very crucial place to have, you know, enhanced cushioning. And they really did that, you know, with the KD13s having placing a Zoom unit directly under, you know, the full length cushioning. And just like the KD12s, the full length Zoom is stitched directly on top of the shoe. Whereas if you were to take out the insole, you guys can see that full length Zoom Air in there, obviously all the way through. What's also great about this setup is that the, you know, the cushion and the midsole is actually cut up into grooves where it adjusts to your foot movements, giving you, you know, more flexibility with every movement that you make.
Let me see if I can show you guys. Take it out a little bit.
Let's see if y'all can see that. I think you guys can see it a little bit, you know, with the lines on the, you know, the cushioning right there. You know, see how it's cut up.
But yeah, the setup on the KD13 is very similar. Thing about this insole, as you guys can see, it's fairly thin. What it kind of reminded me of was, I don't know, this goes way back. I don't know if y'all who watching know these. The insole is very similar to that of the Kobe 6 insole, where it's kind of like styrofoam-like. When you see it, you feel like, you know, it's thin, but the good thing about that type of insole is that, you know, the more you hoop in the shoe, it molds to your foot. And, you know, that is a really good thing, because once you place your foot in this shoe, your foot directly like positions itself to the molded insole, giving you, you know, better support, better lockdown. Your foot is not moving around much. And, you know, I think overall you get a better feel for the cushioning and, you know, better feel for, you know, core feel and your movements. So I think that's really good in that sense. Although I feel like the cushioning in the KD12s were a bit more comfortable. It's a lot more springy and soft. The cushioning on these are a lot more firm. So in a sense where these are not as comfortable like the KD12s, but they are a bit more responsive compared to the KD12s. And also, you know, one good thing about the cushioning on a shoe is that, you know, if you're able to hoop in them, you know, for hours outdoors and you don't get any knee pains or back pains, that means the cushioning on these are A1, which these did for me, as, you know, I've been hooping in these a lot more outdoors, you know, because our access to indoors are very minimal. So I've been hooping, you know, a lot outdoors lately. And, you know, the cushioning on these really hold it down for me outdoors. You know, your boy be having those Derrick Rose type knees, but hey, I ain't got no pains in these, all right? As far as comfort and size fit goes, the KD13s do run true to size, in my opinion. They do feel a bit narrow up top right here, so for all y'all wide footers, y'all might have to go a half size up. And I know I always encourage y'all to go try it out in stores, but you know, with everything going on, you know, right now, I know a lot of you guys aren't able to go out in stores. So if y'all had the KD12s before, and you know, whatever size y'all got in the KD12s, and whatever size that is that fit well for you, get that size in the KD13, because the KD12s and the KD13s are very similar in fitment. Comfort wise, you know, like I mentioned before, they're not super amazing comfortable, you know, whether that's the materials or the cushion, but hey, they perform like hell, I can tell you that. They get the job done performance-wise. But overall, I'm not mad at these. And as far as pricing goes, the KD13 retails for $160. You're paying for what you're getting. You know, there's a lot of good tech in this shoe. You know, it does have top-of-the-line tech compared to, you know, some of the other shoes. Visually, I think certain colorways look better than others. I think all the colorways are the same price, unless they come out with like some, you know, quick strike or limited edition colorway. I think they're all priced at $160. And with it having a $10 bump from last year's KD12 price, is it fairly, you know, better? Does it deserve the $10 increase? I disagree. I don't think so. I wish, you know, it was priced at $150 again, but hey, you know, KD is arguably, you know, the best, if not, you know, second best 1A, 1B to, you know, LeBron being the best player in the league. Hey, his price has got to go up and kind of catch up to LeBron's. I think LeBron's, you know, LeBron's be like 170, 180. KD's getting up there, man. Don't we all miss when KD's shoes were under $100? You know, when he said, you know, I want to make my shoes affordable to everybody, so I made them under $100. I remember, what was it, the KD4s were like $95. But man, hey, that was ages ago. And for my overall rating for the KD13s, I'm gonna give these a score of 4 out of 5. It's very similar to its predecessor, the KD12s, but there were some components on the KD13s that were better than the 12s and vice versa. The performance is still off the charts, the traction is good, the cushioning is awesome, the materials could have definitely been better, and the support and lockdown are, you know, solid. I think the only major upgrades on the KD13s compared to the 12s was definitely the cushioning setup. Having placing the double stack Zoom Air in the forefoot compared to having it in the heel last year, I think, you know, that was a really big plus. I can't really say, you know, the KD13 was disappointing. What I meant by disappointing is that I wish they could have done more from the 13s and the 12s, you know, besides, you know, visually just changing the shoe a little bit. The 12 and the 13s look very similar, y'all. Like, you already see that. The performance, like I said, very similar. But hey, Nike and KD tends to do this. This ain't the first time. Just look at the KD9s and the 10s.
Overall, the KD13 is a phenomenal performance hoop shoe. Just like the KD12s, you know, they're very similar. There's some good components on this one and there's some, you know, better components on that one. It all depends on what your preference, you know, in the shoe and the tech is for you guys. But overall, the KD13 is a great performance hoop shoe. And I know it's difficult for all y'all out there, you know, to be able to go outside, you know, let alone hoop. But when things are good again, which I know they will be, go check out the KD13s. Hope you guys enjoyed that sneaker review on the Nike KD13s. Let me know down in the comment section below, what were some of y'all thoughts on the KD13s? And for some of those who do have the KD13s, what were some of the things you guys like and what are some of the things you guys, you know, didn't like about them? And I know I've said this many times, you know, we are, you know, going through some rough times right now as a whole with everybody in the world. And I just, you know, wish better times are coming. I know that we just gotta stay positive, support each other, and just keep, you know, a positive and supporting mindset, you know, with everything that's going on around the world right now. And I know sooner or later, hopefully sooner, that we all get to go out and start hooping again, you know, with the friends and the homies and everybody, and then just have a good time. But with that being said, you know, your boy's still cranking out, you know, a lot of videos for you guys, whether that's sneaker reviews, you know, I'm really, you know, grinding my butt off, you know, so I'm doing whatever that I can to give you guys, you know, good content, whether that's basketball, sneakers, you know, vlogs, or whatever it is. Actually, you know, I have some really new and different type of content for you guys coming up, so make sure to stay tuned. And for all of those, you know, who are new to the channel, you guys enjoyed the content, you know, make sure to hit that subscribe button and also give this video a thumbs up. You know, it goes a long way. We all just trying to, you know, do our thing out here, you know, whether we are here or across the world back home, we're all just trying to grind. And until next time, it's your boy Nelly Nell from Hoopin' Life. I'm out. Peace. Keep it up, thinking these women excite me. Keep it up, wishing y'all can pass me. Run it up, stepping, I'm moving at high speed. Yeah.